Donald Trump has started a war. Donald Trump has Mueller on his ass. Donald Trump has the midterms on his ass. Donald Trump has incompetence on his ass. Donald Trump has so many things that are bad, that are happening, self-inflicted, to him. So what does he do? He starts a war. He sends a Navy ship with 60 Tomahawks. And he bombs the shit out of Syria, right? And it got me to thinking, maybe you should start a war because you have problems. Like Donald has problems. We as Americans love war. Yes, we do. And if there is a hint of a threat, we're going to get on board. And this is going to raise Donald Trump's approval rating. It's not going to stop the Mueller investigation. It's not going to stop the indictments of Flynn and all these other people. As every time you talk or turn around, someone's getting indicted. But it's going to help Donald Trump. Because we as Americans are patriotic and we're going to get behind this because we are scared. But this isn't going to be a political video. What we can learn from Donald Trump is when you are suffering, you have issues, bad things are going on in your life, perhaps, maybe you need to start a war. Yes, you. But not going out and bombing helpless citizens, but you need to start an economic war. You need to do something radical. You need to enhance and elevate your business game, like a war. What is a war? It's violence. It's extreme actions. It's countermeasures. It's guerrilla warfare. It's airstrikes. It's all this stuff, right? You should do that to your economy. You should cast a war on your personal economy to shake things up and to get things moving up. Maybe you need to tear down what you built. Maybe you need to bomb your economics so you can clear out all of the garbage, all of the rubbish, and then start to come up clean. And, you know, after the war, everyone's patting themselves on the back. It's like, we did this, we did that. War costs money. War creates money. War creates a lot of money. Yes. You need to start a war, a personal war. And with war comes bodies. There's going to be some bodies in this war. It may be your credit. It might be your wife. It might be your husband. It could be because in war, there's a thing called casualties. Sometimes friendly fire will kill your best buddy. Think about that. How do you wage this war on your economics? Well, I was in the United States Army, went through basic training. Basic training is the reprogramming of you so you can follow the directives of the military. They take all of that civilian stuff out of you and they program you. And the ones that they can't program, they get rid of. Article 15, wash them out, medical, whatever. They get rid of them if they can't program them. So you have to reprogram yourself first because basic training comes before they send you out to war. You gotta go to basic training, you gotta go to AIT. They gotta get you acclimated, they gotta get you set up for it. Do you know during the Vietnam War, the Korean War, a lot of people voluntarily went back to kill people? They got that taste of blood in their mouth. They're like, that's good. I want some more of this. They went back to kill people. You gotta develop that warrior mindset. If you want to wage a war on your personal economics, you can't sit back. You can't try to cheat the system. You gotta balls to the wall. You've gotta push forward like you've never pushed before. You've gotta set yourself up like a warrior. You're not gonna win this economic warrior being a pussy, being a little bitch, making weird ass comments on this channel when I'm trying to indoctrinate you with something that's gonna make your life better. It's gonna give you more money. It's gonna give you more personal satisfaction and confidence. So from this day forward, all of the weak little bitches gotta go. Cause I'm training warriors. I'm training warriors to be in this economic war. I'm training people to make more money, to build a life. So that we don't have no time for weak folks. We don't have no time, you know, when we're running the road marches of Coley Coley Pass and singing the cadences and people fell to the wayside. I had this one asshole first sergeant who was like, bending to the wayside, bending to the wayside. Train don't stop. Train don't stop. Johnson to the wayside, Johnson to the wayside, train don't stop, train don't stop. So those of us who wouldn't fall into the wayside, we ran harder while they were falling back. Because in war, everybody ain't gonna win. Everybody's not coming back home. Get yourself in the warrior mindset. You don't want to be Johnson, Johnson to the wayside. You don't want to be Bennett, Bennett to the wayside. You don't want to be Ashford, Ashford to the wayside. Because we're running up this motherfucking mountain. Because we're warriors. We're men. That's what we do. We kill shit and we keep and eat what we kill. But you ain't killing shit. You're trying to hack some shit. You trying to play around. I showed you how my Instagram account went from nothing to starting to grow from start to finish. I don't want that. I ain't interested in that, Glendon. I am giving you the blueprint, the DNA to build your economics. But a lot of you gonna fall to the wayside. Johnson to the wayside. Bennett to the wayside. Ashford to the wayside. Because y'all ain't built for this. Just get ready. Because when you get ready, and you stay ready, you don't have to get ready.